In 2014, Toyota shook the electric vehicle world with a bold claim about a game-changing solid-state battery. They aimed to supercharge their EV lineup by introducing these batteries by 2018 and ultimately having all their electric vehicles powered by them by 2021. However, as years passed, these grand plans seemed to vanish like a distant dream. Fast forward to today, and Toyota has once again sent shockwaves through the EV community. They've declared their ambitious goal of achieving a jaw-dropping 621 miles of range in their EVs by 2027. This bombshell announcement has sparked renewed discussions about Toyota's venture into solid-state battery tech and the potential it holds for the future of electric transportation. But the burning question remains: can Toyota turn its promise into reality, or will it be another case of unfulfilled aspirations? In today's video, we'll dig deep into Toyota's history with solid-state batteries, the hurdles they must overcome, and the skepticism surrounding their recent declaration. Join us on this electrifying journey as we uncover Toyota's quest for groundbreaking battery technology that could redefine the EV landscape. Toyota's solid-state battery technology has been shrouded in a cloak of secrecy, a stark departure from the automotive industry's usual practice of openly sharing details about groundbreaking innovations. This deliberate lack of transparency has understandably raised eyebrows and led to a healthy dose of skepticism. Many are left wondering if these enigmatic batteries are anything more than concepts on paper. Even though Toyota is a heavyweight in the global automotive arena, they haven't been immune to criticism for their somewhat cautious approach to electric vehicles and their reservations about the environmental benefits of going electric. It's important to highlight that Toyota is currently manufacturing its batteries, predominantly nickel metal hydride batteries employed in their Lexus electric vehicles. However, these production lines were established roughly 2 decades ago, rendering this battery technology considerably older and heavier compared to modern lithium-based alternatives. Nonetheless, Toyota boldly asserts that its upcoming electric vehicles will usher in a 20% reduction in manufacturing costs compared to the prevailing battery technology. Their ambitious roadmap projects an impressive range of 800 kilometers by 2026, with that number soaring to over 1,000 kilometers by 2027. Furthermore, Toyota is setting its sights on delivering rapid charging capabilities, enabling their electric vehicles to charge from 10% to 80% in under 20 minutes, a significant leap forward in charging speeds. These developments signify a potential turning point in the electric vehicle landscape. Looking into the future, Toyota has outlined its plan to introduce a more cost-effective lithium-ion phosphate or LFP battery option, likely in late 2026 or possibly 2027. This move is expected to bolster cost savings, potentially reaching a remarkable 40%, while simultaneously increasing the driving range by 20%. However, it's important to note that the extended range will still cap at 373 miles. Essentially, Toyota is signaling its ability to enhance the performance of existing LFP batteries, which are currently manufactured by companies such as CATL and BYD. This upgraded battery is anticipated to possess a charging capability, taking it from 10% to 80% in just 30 minutes. It's worth mentioning that there are already LFP batteries available in the market with notably faster charging capabilities, so this may not represent a groundbreaking advancement. Certain LFP batteries currently on the market boast impressive energy density levels. It's worth noting that Toyota, while not yet utilizing these advanced LFP batteries, does have access to remarkable options. For example, the latest iteration of Gotham High-Tech's LFP batteries and CATL's newer LFP batteries exhibit the energy density of approximately 200 watts per kilogram, showcasing promising developments within this field. When we examine these remarkable batteries, it becomes apparent that Toyota's plans may not be as groundbreaking as initially perceived. The timeline for implementing LFP batteries in vehicles outside of China, potentially by 2027, raises questions. Some speculate that Toyota might be contemplating the development of their own LFP cells based on this information. Turning our attention to Toyota's recently unveiled roadmap for EVs and battery technology, it has left many puzzled. Upon closer scrutiny, it appears that the information presented may be subject to change. Some critics argue that the roadmap resembles a well-crafted PowerPoint presentation intended for internal Toyota meetings, possibly an effort to address the media and mitigate criticism. Whether this perspective holds is a matter of ongoing debate. What are your thoughts on this? Do you share this interpretation, or do you see it differently? Feel free to share your opinion in the comments section below. According to Toyota's projections, the maximum driving range is expected to hover around 1,000 kilometers from 2027 to 2028, coinciding with the anticipated launch of their first-generation solid-state batteries. It's important to note that this projection doesn't specify the type of vehicle for which this battery is intended. It could be designed for a high-performance sports car with exceptional aerodynamics, or perhaps an SUV, making it challenging to arrive at definitive conclusions. Furthermore, Toyota has stated that its upcoming version of the solid-state batteries, scheduled for release in 2027, will possess the remarkable capability to charge up to 80% of its capacity in just 10 minutes. While achieving a 10-minute 80% charge would indeed be impressive, it's worth noting that several other automakers have already announced plans to introduce batteries with similar rapid charging capabilities within the next 12 to 24 months. Consequently, Toyota's timeline for achieving such charging speeds may not be as groundbreaking as it initially appears. Toyota's roadmap also mentions a second-generation solid-state battery with an expected range of 1,200 kilometers. Furthermore, they hint at further improvements, potentially reaching an astonishing 932 miles of range or 1,500 kilometers. These claims, however, raise legitimate questions. Why pursue such extensive ranges when more practical approaches involving reducing battery pack size, lightening the vehicle, and making it more cost-effective for both operation and purchase? The notion of a 1,500-kilometer range is undeniably extravagant, particularly considering that no internal combustion engine vehicle in the world currently offers such extensive ranges. Toyota's commitment to this audacious claim does appear somewhat dubious, almost as if they've chosen this figure arbitrarily to generate excitement. It's essential to highlight that their electric vehicle production accounts for a mere 0.2% of their total vehicle production worldwide. Toyota is actively working to reduce the thickness of its battery packs, citing benefits such as enhanced passenger comfort and improved aerodynamic efficiency due to reduced vehicle height. This emphasis on volumetric energy density aligns with the direction taken by CATL, a prominent Chinese battery manufacturer, which claims that its new Cheetah battery boasts significantly superior volumetric energy density compared to current Tesla battery packs using 4680 cells. Manufacturers throughout the industry are diligently working on enhancing this aspect of battery technology. Furthermore, Toyota revealed that the battery in their current BZ4X model measures 150 millimeters or 5.9 inches, including its casing, which is relatively wide. To put this into perspective, BYD's Blade battery is approximately one quarter of that thickness. Toyota aims to reduce the battery thickness to 120 millimeters or 4.7 inches for regular vehicles, and even further to 100 millimeters or 3.9 inches for sports cars. Nevertheless, it's a valid point to consider whether Toyota's resources could be more effectively utilized by forming strong partnerships with established battery companies, rather than embarking on the development of their enigmatic battery package. Surprisingly, there has been a conspicuous absence of information regarding this venture, despite persistent inquiries from journalists eager to see a pre-production prototype. Toyota had even suggested back in 2015 that such a prototype was forthcoming, yet it has not materialized. Thus, questions remain, and observers eagerly await further developments of this intriguing yet enigmatic aspect of Toyota's endeavors. Have you heard that BYD has urged Chinese carmakers to unite and smash the traditional auto industry? Watch this video and find out what this is all about. See you there.